In case you were busy doing other things like living your life, you may have missed the TV and Twitter battle royale between Fox's Sean Hannity and Jimmy Kimmel. Without dragging you into the juvenile back and forth over who's more perverted and who's gayer. Yeah, really. This spat was over a sketch Kimmel did in which he mocked Melania Trump's accent.
This is brutal. Liberal Jimmy Kimmel making fun of the First Lady of the United States and her involvement in the White House Easter egg roll, even her accents. Jimmy, you're a despicable disgrace. Take a look.
No White House Easter celebration would be complete without story time from our First Lady.
Never stop exploring, because life would be boring. Be clever and curious, just like a cat. Ask lots of questions about this and that.
About this and that.
Ask Clown Kimmel. Now, I gotta tell you something. What a disgrace. Hey, Mr. Kimmel, that's her fifth language. How many do you speak?
Kimmel tried to put an end to it by tweeting this statement yesterday in part, "While I admit I did have fun with our back and forth, after some thought, I realize that the level of vitriol from all sides, mine and me included, does nothing good for anyone and is in fact harmful to our country." So are we done yet? No. Sean Hannity plans to address it on tonight's show in just a few hours. In tonight's News on the News, Brian, I want to go to you first.
Oh.
Is this just a symptom of, like, living in Trump Twitter, where two grown men feel emboldened to go on Twitter and engage in some of the dumbest, pettiest, most childish arguments we have seen in recent memory?
Well, Sean Hannity likes to call me Humpty Dumpty.
Oh, that's nice.
So I don't know how much I can speak to this. I don't want to have to pick a side
right here.
I think, you know, I wish for the days of Johnny Carson and Walter Cronkite, mm-hmm. because this is what we have now in terms of comedians and people who pretend to be news anchors. Mm-hmm. Hannity, I think, will try to exploit this, keep it going tonight.
Uh-huh.
That is his tendency to do so. He also wants to distract from various news stories. You have Michael Cohen, Trump's personal attorney, getting raided by the FBI today. Hannity's going to have to do something to avoid talking about that.
Hmm.
So I think he'll attack Jimmy Kimmel again.
Andy, this is a rhetorical question.
Sure.
Who won?
Well, I guess I'll answer it rhetorically.
Okay.
It depends how you look at it. Hannity and Kimmel both got exactly what they wanted out of their dumb fight. Both of their respective popularities will go up with their respective in-groups, and that's all anybody cares about these days, particularly on social media. So if you want to look at it that way, they both won. If you want to look at it in a larger way, we all lost.
Yeah.
Because it happened. It is my express belief that social media, particularly Twitter, although I'm not on Facebook, I can't speak to it, but particularly Twitter, is killing IQ points. I think we are much more tribal than we have been, at least in my adult lifetime. And I think a lot of that has to do with social media and with the fact that very few people are interested in convincing other people of anything, of making convincing arguments. They just want points and applause from the people who already agree with them. So, like I said, they both won in that sense. They both have their crowds doing it. The real winner also might be me, because this inane fight has driven me mostly off Twitter.
Oh, okay.
So I think that's a win for me.
Listen, let me just say, this does not require any commentary, but let me just say, Sean Hannity, Jimmy Kimmel, two men I actually respect for very different reasons. I was real disappointed to see both of them doing this stuff on Twitter. Dave, mostly for Kimmel's side, because it wasn't funny.
Yeah.
This is like the lowest hanging fruit, to play some sound of someone talking in a way that could you think, you know, sounds funny, and then just make fun of the accent. I mean, there is a treasure trove of stuff to go after in this administration. Can we class up the joint?
Yeah, well, I do. Kimmel is a funny guy.
Yes,
at times.
Very.
But he's got two modes. He's either funny or insufferable. And this was just bad. I mean, there wasn't one joke in his response. There wasn't one good. Watching the tape, Hannity's thing was funnier than Kimmel's, but he wasn't trying to be funny, so it wasn't a good look.
Unintentionally.
But they both, the thing, I hate, it's everything I hate about the left Sean Hannity is now embracing. It's like, I agree with you, it's not funny, but it doesn't make him a despicable human being because he made a joke about her accent. And then, of course, the other hypocrisy is that if anybody, if any right-wing comedian, there's a few of us, if any right-wing comedian out there made fun of, like, you know, an accent of a left-wing administration, they'd be all on top of them.
Yes.
But because it's Trump, the rules are up. So it's just all this hypocrisy, and it's phony. And like you said, everyone's just kind of, you know, playing to their dumb base.
And the other hypocrisy is, of course, the idea that Hannity is outraged about someone going after a first lady is, I mean, you have to be kidding me.
Well, Brian,
but just quickly, the flip of that is Jimmy Kimmel would never have made jokes about Michelle Obama like this.
No, right, but to these points, Brian, do you think Sean Hannity, Jimmy Kimmel are now just performers? Do either of them believe what they're talking about, what they're saying now? Or is it all just for sort of clicks, tweets, likes?
Well, I thought Kimmel sounded genuine, talking about healthcare last year, talking about his child. There were times where he seems very sincere. I think there are also times Hannity seems sincere. But I know that when I see Hannity at events, when I see him at parties, he's a lot nicer to me in person than he ever is on TV. And, of course, you know, that's the bottom line.
Yeah.
I do think Kimmel was trying to make one important point about Hannity, and that's about his deference to the president. And that is something that Kimmel was trying to say and got lost in all the name-calling. If we could just have timeouts for these guys, you know, just basic daycare sort of things, that would help a lot.